I've been teaching for almost 39 years. I started teaching in 1970 after graduation in March or April, and then June, I was in a Chinese Buddhist school, which I taught for 28 years, after which I taught in another Chinese school, a sister Chinese Buddhist school, for 2 years before I came to FE. I am on my 9th year here in FE. Going on 9.
Number 2, how do you start the lesson?
Well, it depends if it is a lecture or a love subject. If it's a love subject, if we are having an experiment, of course, I have to discuss first the pre-lab. No? We have the pre-lab discussion wherein we discuss the procedure of the experiment and the precautionary measures and all that. If it's a lecture, it starts with, of course, motivating them to get interested in the lesson by asking them some questions or telling them some related stories about the lesson, something like that.
Do you follow some class routine?
There are certain routine activities that I do in class, like in checking of the attendance, and then reminding students about their deficiencies, giving feedback. Those are routinary.
What is your specialized subject?
Well, I teach science, so that's my specialization, as well as education, because my master's degree is in science education. So I used to teach education. I took 2A in another program. It's not an undergrad program, but it is considered a graduate program because my students have already finished another course, and then they are taking education only. I also had some years of teaching in a graduate school where I taught also education subjects, particularly pedagogical, something to do with principles of teaching.
What are the strategies you use in teaching?
I use a lot of strategies, different strategies, because I don't believe in just one particular strategy. You know, I believe that there is a number of strategies that you can use. So I am eclectic. Now I put together the good things about certain strategies, combination of different strategies.
Mm-hmm. How do you assess your students' performance?
Well, I call my assessments authentic assessments, because they are supposed to measure students' cognitive, psychomotor, and affective learning. So a variety of assessments are used. So some of them are in portfolio. I require them to make a portfolio of their learning. When I was teaching in the graduate school, since my students are all teachers, I asked them to prepare a teaching portfolio. So I believe portfolio is a good assessment tool. Secondly, I also require my students to make reflections after each activity. I also expect them to do some projects, research, reaction paper, as well as special studies on particular issues with regard to our lesson, with regard to the subject that I'm teaching.
What instrument you often use in the class?
The piano instrument.
Visual aid.
Oh, that's right. Yeah. My audiovisual aids would include, of course, a space within the OHP, and then I also have a PowerPoint presentation, as well as charts and tables, and of course the usual, of course, myself. No, I have to make use of myself as the best audiovisual material. So I have to change my voice. I have to make some body language. So in that way, they're able to understand my lesson through my own gestures and my speaking voice. You know, diba? Sometimes PowerPoints cannot be easily used because of the laptop and the DLP problems. You know, sometimes they are not compatible. So you really have to have a backup in the sense that you can also do the thing you have planned for the day by yourself. That's what you call flexibility and innovation. Part of my routine.
We often give quizzes or activities.
Yeah, of course. It's one way of knowing whether your students are able to get your points or are learning your lesson, that you are able to realize your objectives for the day. So I give quizzes. But the quizzes are not as often and are not surprise quizzes, because I don't believe in surprise quizzes. So the quizzes are usually given after a particular lesson is done. So this is what I call a check-up quiz. And activities, of course, I always have some activities for every lesson that I teach, because I believe that students should have an active part in the learning. You know? After I've done my part explaining, then they have to do some things also. That way, I also am able to find out whether there is understanding and learning of the lesson.
What kind of formative tests are you?
Formative tests are usually in the form of multiple choice. It's easy for students to answer the multiple choice, but it's not that easy to make multiple choice questions. But I think that's the best formative test that I give. But in the major test, I would include modified true or false questions and essay questions.
How do you deal about the learning problems of your students?
Learning problems. So I try to assist them and try to adjust to their learning styles, you know, because students have different learning styles. So even if I teach the same subject to different sections, I do different strategies for each of them, because each section is a bunch of different personalities and different learning styles, you know. So I try to adjust to their learning needs.